if I'm in pain from a 9-year-old injury of my brother dying, if I'm in pain from, you know, my father's reaction to my brother dying, all of these things that build up and you kind of have like, you know I've had the veneer, like it doesn't matter. I'm cool with it. It does matter. And it is a deep injury. And until you really repair your own injuries, you're not very useful to other people. So if you want to have a meaningful existence or life, and I want to do things that are impactful and make change, then I need to get real about it, you know? And so I had to get real with myself, which I thought I'd been being real forever. And then I was like, ugh, gross. I have to unpeel this. Like, it was so, it's such a cliche also. Like me, you know, turning at 40 and going my midlife crisis and all of this identity discovery, what my identity is and my identity crisis. So it's all like blah, 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 blah. But I figure, you know what? I've made a career out of oversharing. This is something worthwhile because not everybody can afford it. So We all are recovering from some injury we had, you know, as a child. But, you know, there's a part of me that's very cynical and that's very much a realist. So I have a hard time with a lot of this LA mumbo jumbo, and spirituality can stink of mumbo jumbo a lot of the time. That's why I had a hard time with therapy, because I thought it represented that. Like, navel gazing after I have a show and books about me, I'm going to go talk about myself for 2 hours. Like, what kind of loser am I? So that's, you know, It was all about ego. Like, I can't, it's too much. You know what I mean? Yeah. I'm a narcissist.
Yeah.
When I realized I had to go see somebody, it was after the election, and I just had such outrage and my anger was at a 10 all the time. And I couldn't work. I couldn't focus on anything but the news and this 24-hour spin cycle that it created. And I just was like, oh my God, I have to harness this anger into something powerful and good, not this. I can't be this way all the time. And they were like robbing me of my life, this administration, and I allowed them to. And I was like, no, I'm not doing this. So I went, you know, there for that. And what I uncovered through seeing this psychiatrist, because for the first 3 sessions, all I did was bitch and moan about Donald Trump. And I got a lot out of it. I mean, I would have paid him more. But after 3 sessions, like, we started to get real and started talking about what Donald Trump's, like, presidency represented to me, which was an unhinged childhood when things were completely out of control. So for the first time in my adult life, things felt completely out of control. And it, like, reminded me of my brother going off and saying he was going to be right back and dying. Like, that was the other time my life was out of control. So that's why it triggered all this stuff on me. And so talking to somebody and having somebody who has a degree in, you know, psychiatry and other things, telling you, hey, don't minimize an incident. Just because you weren't raped or sexually assaulted, you have a right to be in pain. You lost your brother, that's painful. You probably haven't matured much beyond that emotionally when it comes to men at 9 years, from 9 years old. And I was like, no, that's exactly what's happening. And once somebody said that to me, I'm like, oh my God, is it that obvious? Like, that's how basic this all is? I answer, yes, it is. And if you don't ask questions like that or admit it to yourself, then you're just kind of masking pain.